Hi there, it's V from Helping Ninja. On this channel we talk about Raspberry Pi, how awesome it is, what can you do with it and so on. But did you actually try to buy one in the last few months? Heck, it might be almost whole year by now? If you did, you probably noticed that it is very hard to find some in stock somewhere. There are even dedicated web pages today that look and hunt for Raspberry Pis, like rpilocator.com. I know, it's crazy. It's because there's now long-term shortage of chips and semiconductors that are needed to manufacture Raspberry Pis. You've probably heard about this situation. It's not only affecting Raspberry Pi market, but beer markets also, like car production, graphic cards and many other things. The latest official news is sadly from April 2022, basically saying that there is currently enough supply to meet the needs of big commercial and industrial customers. Unfortunately, with cost of constrained supply for an individual customer. Forecasting that by the end of the summer or early autumn 2022, we should see some increase in the availability of Raspberry Pis to us hobbyists. So, fingers crossed. But we love our Raspberry Pis. So, until there are enough Raspberry Pis to meet the demand, I'm going to show you how you can go around this problem using virtual machines so you can build stuff on your Raspberry Pi even when you don't have one right now. And I'll show you how to prepare yourself to migrate your things from virtual machine to actual real-life Raspberry Pi after you will be able to get one. Let me show you how to build your Raspberry Pi as virtual machine.
I'll use VirtualBox on my Windows PC. If you want to know how to do this on different OSs, let me know in the comments. Okay, let's download VirtualBox. Go to this page, virtualbox.wiki/downloads. Download VirtualBox, Windows hosts in my case. And download VirtualBox extension pack. We want to have USB support and other things. Wait for the download to finish and install VirtualBox. Don't worry, links will be in the description down below. If the extension pack won't install itself by double-clicking on it, you can install it manually or check if the installation was successful like this. Go to File, Preferences, Extensions, and you should see Oracle VM VirtualBox extension pack here. If you do not, just click this folder with plus icon, find the downloaded extension pack and install it manually. Now we need to download that image of Raspberry Pi from here. Again, the link will be in the description down below. Scroll down and choose Raspberry Pi desktop compatible with PC or Mac. Create a virtual machine for your Raspberry Pi like this. Machine, new, name it, let's say Raspberry Pi. Machine folder, in my case, it's VMS, it's short for virtual machines. Type Linux version, pick Debian 64-bit. Let's say we will give it at least 4 GB of RAM and we'll create new hard drive for it now. Choose a file location for the virtual disk drive and hard disk file type use VDI, that's VirtualBox disk image. And let's make it at least 16 GB in size. Be careful here. Pick at least 16 GB. I've tried it with 8 and that's not enough. The installation process will fail if you pick too little. And hit create. Now let's insert the downloaded installation image into this virtual machine. Settings, storage, control ID, empty, choose disk file and point to the downloaded file and hit open. Okay. Start the machine, pick graphical install, choose your language and go through this drive configuration. Pick all files in one partition, continue, finish partitioning, and write changes to disks. Yes. And let the installation process continue. Confirm installation of Grub bootloader. Yes. Pick the only drive it offers, its dev SDA, and hit continue. After the installation, there are a few things to set up, like a country in which we are, language and keyboard layout. Set the username and password. I'll put in Pi as username and password. And I'll skip the download of updates to not waste your time now. But you can do it at this point if you would like to. In virtual machine settings, I recommend you to set the network type to the bridged adapter, so the Raspberry Pi is on the same network as your other devices, not hidden behind your host computer. This way you can connect to your Raspberry Pi via SSH from all kinds of devices on your network. Start Raspberry Pi again. So here you are in your Raspberry Pi. Let me show you your IP. You can use it later to connect to this virtual Pi. IP ADDR show or hostname-i, that's your Pi address right here. If you want to assign a static IP address to this Pi, I will put a link in the corner of this video. Now, I would strongly recommend keeping its configuration and data very clean and organized, because there is no easy way to migrate this virtual Pi to a real one. Mainly because of different processor architectures used in PCs and in Raspberry Pi. Raspberry Pi uses special low energy consumption ARM processors. If you want a deeper dive on how to emulate ARM processors on Macs or PCs, let me know in the comment section down below. Now, the best way to migrate data from virtual machine to an actual Raspberry Pi is to install clean Raspberry Pi, if and when it arrives, and migrate only data to it. I use my Raspberry Pi mainly as a cheap small server, and I run everything in Docker containers, so I will be able to easily migrate stuff between computers. Let me show you what I have in mind. Look at this Docker structure. I'll use the tree command. Let me install the tree quickly. Sudo apt install tree. And from the home directory, run tree docker. I got all the configuration files here in this one Docker directory. And I've got all the Docker volume data or actual files of servers in slash sre folder. Let me show you. 3-d-lL2/sre. The dash D means it will show only directories. There are a lot of files, and I want to show you the structure of this folder. And dash L2 will show you only two sublevels of directories. Now, let's say I would like to migrate all these things I've created to my new Raspberry Pi. Easy enough. I'll just install brand new Raspberry Pi, install Docker, and few things here and there I like. And now I just copy these two folders, Docker and the content of the SRV, to the new Raspberry. Maybe the contents of my whole home directory. I launch the containers and I'm good to go.
I know. It's not ideal. It's not like having actual Raspberry Pi, but it works and it's simple enough. And at least it enables you to prepare your stuff, servers and scripts beforehand, before you can actually buy your Raspberry Pi, so you are saving time. That's gonna count for something. What do you think? Would this workaround work for you? Let me know in the comments. And if this use case won't help you, in the next video I'll present to you a few alternatives to Raspberry Pi which you can still buy these days for a reasonable price. So stay tuned. If this kind of video helps you, please do consider subscribing to my channel and hitting that like button. Thanks for watching. Bye.